Yes, I, praising King Selassie. Lo and behold, another video on the communication channels. The word, sometimes referred to as media, news. Really, in a broader perspective, this should be considered any content generated that is seen or heard or otherwise felt by senses. You know, these are institutionally based platforms. They exist to project a message for a certain people. There are no institutions controlled by poor people. There are those that claim to be, but the basis for any institution is capital. And poor people don't have that. So there's never going to be adequate representation for poor people in this Babylonian system, whatever you call it. It traces itself to the Babylonian roots. And there's an objective, I suppose, to any mission. And this mission's objective is to seek glory for man. So how is this done? How are the communication channels acting in this way? So, you know, you have mainstream communication channels, and then you have not so mainstream. And these not so mainstream communication channels, you know, they claim to be the other, you know, the opposite, or the rival of the mainstream. Yet if you listen close enough or watch, you'll see that they're covering the same issues. And in fact, those that claim to be separate, you know, from the establishment, don't actually cover issues that do affect people, that do matter. So there's a deception. There's a lie built in the lie. And this is, you know, to draw people in, to, you know, because if people question what they're being told, then the message is not going to get across. So you have to condition people to not question what the message is. And by not addressing certain material, let's say, whether it be bioinformatics, you know, how all megadata is used for a behavioral modification, and really, you know, inform people, then it basically is gossip. I mean, you know, there's certain issues that are covered that could be covered, but not to the extent that they are. And so if you're not talking about serious matters, you're sending a message to say that this does not matter. And it's very effective. People are consumed, for the most part. Now, there's a group of people that are highly educated and are benefiting from this status quo, whatever, the way, the Babylonian way. And so, although they're the ones that are aware of how it works, they're not going to make a fuss. Everyone's selling them, these people are selling themselves on a idea that this is progression, civilization. Other people will get educated. They'll also have the hand-me-downs and the incentives provided to keep people moving, building up this machine. It's all moving towards something, right? This is like, so, you know, that's true. It is. And where is it going? Yeah. News, what are they doing? Institutional, industrial based. The private news, the so-called commercial news, promotes different products and services directly. That's built into the culture. So like the Super Bowl in the United States, the most watched program all year, is when all the people are supposed to unite. And the commercials happen to be, you know, some of the highlights, the attraction. So this is built into the culture. Those are providing incentives for people. This is drug. People are taking drugs. They're addicted. It's not good for them. They're not looking any better. Like, they're losing friends. All these bad things are happening, and yet they still do the same thing because they're hooked. There's these so-called experts, you know, that are brought on to these programs, and they're supposed to be informing people about what it is that they need to know. Both commercial and so-called non-commercial dependent programming, like PBS, is dependent, it's publicly funded, and it privately benefited. So it's going to project a message for whatever you want to call the ruling elite. Obviously, people with wealth that would like to keep what they have, and the whatever taxpayer dollars paying for it. Taxes are good for services for the public. It's just the question is, what is the message that's being sent? These, you know, so-called independent programming, they're not changing the narrative very much, if you notice. For example, with the last administration, federal, to the pedophile administration, Drone Bomber's a pedophile, you really don't have, you don't notice. So there must not be too much of an ideological difference between these characters or their associates, parties. And this communication channel is one way that you can see this. This becomes evident. Now, there's a lot of railing on the media because this is all the design. If you would like to do away with something, if you can give the appearance of it obnoxiously so that it turns people away, then that, whatever that threat happens to be, will disintegrate. It will diminish its effect on the population to influence. And, you know, this character, he's a body bag, you know, beat him up, you know, he takes the blow. There's a Latin term, you know, these are not new. And the other thing is that when Rome adopted the two consul system, they also had a system before where there would be pretender emperors, and these weren't actual, so, you know, rulers. Because when you think about a ruler, you think it's about a commander. Somebody's gonna, you know, give the order of the day, And, you know, a pretender is just what it says. They're going to act to be the ruler. Now, what effect does that have? It gives allegiance to the structure as a whole. Because if this person is getting the support and they're not actually doing the ruling, then it shows of the power of the deception. And this is valuable to the man, you know, to deceive people, to make people believe that they're actually working towards something that's good, that's righteous, that's worthy. You wouldn't get people to work if you kept convincing them they're working for no good cause. So the idea with the body bag is that it's the deflector. You're going to take the issues, yeah, and you're gonna take the position opposite to where you would like to see the majority of people go. Now the minority is already ruling the game, and they have, you know, people at their disposal, because it's just, you face it, there's people out here that just they'll do anything to suck Babylon's thing. That's just who they, that's just what it is, man. You know, there's evil that exists. There's people that would admit that they're evil, if not openly inside. That's even more evil than the other. So you know it, I know it. They're out there. They're willing to work for anything. There's people that convince themselves that they're good, and go to church and whatnot. But they've been brought into this structure, and they've been taught to believe in it, so that they'll do anything in the chain of command. Out there at the top, they're never at the top. See, even the Christ said the kings of earth had their benefactors. You know, it's real. You know, there's a network because they're all benefiting. And they realize they can't really exist without each other. They'd rather not fight with each other, because divided they'll fall. So these folks are at the top. They compete with each other for fun. When it comes down to it, they're gonna stick together. Whereas the people at the bottom are being divided. And this is the reason, because of these communication channels. They're blowing up these issues that people are divided on. You know, abortion, racism, whatever it seems that you can actually divide people on the bottom. Because remember, those folks that claim to be in this position, that position, they're going home. They've got all this wealth. At the end of the day, they're not really, they're not thinking about a woman that's, you know, having an abortion or whatever else they claim to be, right? People are going to place our positions as part of the role. That's what they're hired to do, and that is to split people. It's hard to really say what these people think, but what you can conclude is that they are suckers. They're going to work for the man. You know, I've met these folks in my life, you know, in the business environment, and they're the type that just, you know, bullshit their way. They do as little work as possible, and they try to get the most as they can. And that's their focus. Their goal is to get as much as they can.